July 2020 has us going full speed ahead into what we must address based on past fears. It's a lot of momentum, but a lot of it circles around backwards, asking us to really look back at where we have come to make us more comfortable now. However, now really is not the time for the comfortable, even though I think we are up for the challenge of heading straight through the obstacles instead of sidestepping them, as indicated in this July 2020 astrology. If you are excited to dive into what the month of July 2020 has in store collectively, and also dive into some tarot and oracle deck guidance at the end, make sure that you like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you are always up to date with what the stars have in store for you. Hi, I'm Maren. I am an astrologer, an author, and a witch. Proudly out of the broom closet, I combine traditional astrological techniques with modern psychological counseling dynamics in order to provide grounded spiritual guidance. So I have already made full videos for each sign for July coming up, so you can check out your monthly forecast videos down below. The playlist will be linked. So after this video, you can see how specifically these transits will be showing up in your own natal chart. This video is also brought to you by BetterHelp. BetterHelp is an online service connecting you with licensed, board-certified therapists who are certified in their state. You can sign up on this link and get connected with a therapist in under 24 hours. BetterHelp also connects through mobile devices such as mobile phone, computer, or tablet, and you can reach out and talk with your therapist over message, phone call, or video chat. BetterHelp also has group in our sessions where you are able to connect and meet with others in the program to talk about things like relationships and anxiety to better manage those areas. BetterHelp costs $65 a week and financial aid plans are available for those who qualify. BetterHelp is not a crisis hotline. Resources for that will be below, but it is available worldwide. To sign up, you can visit the link in the description to head straight over to the BetterHelp website and go over a brief sign-up process to comprehensively find the exact therapist in under 24 hours who really suits you and your needs and can help get you to the place and get the help that you need. So starting out on the first, Saturn retrogrades back into Capricorn. This is a really important part of 2020, and I have a full video up on Saturn in Aquarius because Saturn will be in Aquarius. It entered Aquarius earlier this year. It's retrograding back into Capricorn, and then it will be going ahead in Aquarius back for the next 3 years, starting soon. So Saturn entered Aquarius, and it signaled new limits and boundaries in this air sign of tangible barriers between us and other people, and the social distancing is textbook Saturn in Aquarius, limits between us collectively, distance between people as part of a larger group. Aquarius as the fixed air sign is the concentration of ideas, and that is the collective energy. And right now, more than ever, that is apparent with ideological, polarized, very polarized, but very insistent ideological stances amidst this larger whole. And Saturn now retrograding back into Capricorn is significant because it is returning to a few of the themes of institutional breakdown, of rethinking the ways in which we have torn away some of the more dense structures, because Saturn in Capricorn is top-down boundaries. It is how do I limit and how do I make smaller. Saturn in Aquarius is bottom-up boundaries. It is how do I include, how do I create a foundation for the future. And so we've planted the seeds to move forward, and right now Saturn has to do a bit more dirty work of moving back, of breaking down even further. Like, I'm seeing it as a tree was cut down, but there's still a stump, so it's like, no, like, you didn't get away, and now there's the wood chopper, like, chopping down the stump of the tree. Like, we have to really get out all the gunk of these institutions. We have to really go back and clean everything out, because we can't have a foundation that's, like, half the old wood. We have to have it all new concrete. And I get into it more in that video about what to expect, but also in my coronavirus videos, I get into what I expect this to signal as far as some restrictions being eased, because I do see it as Saturn leaving Aquarius for its quick little retrograde dip back into Cap, being like, okay, like, restrictions are kind of coming off. But then Saturn is also meeting Jupiter and Pluto, which is a massive collective implosion that happened in January and signaled, like, basically this shit taking off. So I don't have bright, happy expectations for Saturn re-entering Capricorn, but also, I mean, I'm not, like, overwhelmingly. I mean, I just don't really swing. I don't sugarcoat, but I also don't fear hype. Like, I'm just telling you like it is, that this is not cute, but it's, I mean, it's dramatic and it's entertaining. I guess you can see the world like that when you're just, you know, watching from the spiritual point of view and you're not like engaging in the trauma drama. It's also significant for those of you who might have your Saturn in Capricorn that it is one final little return to your Saturn return. It'll depend on how late in Capricorn your Saturn is. Like, if your Saturn is at 1 degree of Capricorn, it's not really going to do much. But if your Saturn is at 28, 29 degrees, this could definitely be a stark return to tying up some loose ends around your Saturn return. So that's another thing. Then on the 5th, there's a lunar eclipse full moon at 13 degrees of Capricorn. I have a full video on this lunar eclipse where it goes really in depth, but this is like a markedly sober, harsh letting go. It's an eruption to an 18th month chapter of our lives of really breaking down these structures that we hold in the Capricorn house and our chart. If you know what that is, let me know down below, because this is one final hurrah this month to like sticking the nail in the coffin to that Capricorn area of life. But we're having the moon in Capricorn where it is in the decan of Mars, where it is very uncomfortable and it is very foreign and it is like we're scared shitless and we feel dreary and cold, and the emotional center is like a complete mess during this time period, if I'm very honest. And then the sun though is in Cancer in this Venus ruled decan, where the authority we see in the light at the end of the tunnel is really indicating that we see there being potential in where we're going. We are acknowledging the fact that we have to stick our nose to the grindstone and we have to really put in the work to not go around the boundaries, but like dig in deeper to letting everything come up that's a shadow, that's a fear, that's a feeling of scarcity, that's a block. We have to let everything become so apparent that there's nothing left to ram through. Like, we are going like, I'm gonna get the facial and the facialist is gonna do every single extraction on my face, even though it hurts a little bit, because I do not want to have a single zit on my face. I actually don't find extractions hurt very much, but I know other people do, and my inner corner is coming up right now, so I might be looking a complete mess. This is how we're feeling on this lunar eclipse. The sun in Cancer is gonna be conjunct. My ring is falling, my graduation ring. I graduated today. I'm prepping this at the end of May because I film really fucking far ahead, and I graduated from college today, and this is my class ring. I'm talking really fast because this is how I talk normally when I'm not filming, so that people comment all the time that I talk quickly, and I'm like, bitch, I'm literally a fucking metronome for you guys. In real life, I listen to my podcast at 2 to 2.5x speed. It's just more convenient for the pace in which I cognitively operate. But back to this lunation, I apologize for the commercial break. We have Mercury retrograde under the sun's beams with sun in Cancer, and this doesn't indicate this much being communicated or illuminated right now, but this really making itself known in the months to come, like some sort of communication around authority figures that we're supposed to be nurturing coming out as not happening will not surprise me. And the emphasis in Capricorn, along with the scary mafia of Saturn, Jupiter, Pluto, is like the emotions are getting completely just you get what I mean. I'm not trying to make a big deal out of it, but it's kind of like if there's something to make a big deal out of this summer, it's going to be this fucking eclipse. Gemini, there's still Venus in Gemini squaring Neptune, so like, don't be delusional. There's a complex and harsh lunation here that we seem to be collectively on board with. Like, there's aspects indicated here of cooperation and reception and seeing the parts that are coming together as necessary. And there's this massive purging of the shadow that has to take place. We see that there's light at the end of the tunnel, because that light at the end of the tunnel is our own internal source. That when we pull out all the gunk that was familiar discomfort, we can see the purity of the internal vibrancy within. On the 12th, then, Mercury is stationing direct at 5 degrees of Cancer. I've also made a full video on this, Mercury retrograde in Cancer. This Mercury retrograde is more pertinent than usual because Mercury retrogrades in and of themselves, like I always say, aren't that big of a deal. Like, Mercury retrograde happens every 3 months. They happen 3 times a year about. They are normal times of tech shit and bullshit and communication. I'm cussing a lot in this video. I'm kind of into it, though. They're pretty, like, normal, but because this one is in conversation with so many of the major players of 2020, like so many major 2020 transits are being aspected by this Mercury retrograde, it's kind of like the communication shit that we're having trouble with right now is playing into the larger themes, and this is a more important Mercury retrograde than usual, and it really deals with reevaluating emotional priorities and how we make ourselves feel comfort and what we consider valuable at the core of our life. Like, we're reevaluating what our hierarchy of needs really is so that we're not bullshitting around, pleasing other people, and feeling arbitrarily obligated to a social construct of family which in no way supports our best interest. I say this a lot, but the idea of family as something more, like, the idea of it being indebted to those that you're blood related to is a social construct, and you can choose for family to be something that is much more than feeling obligated to someone just because there's some sort of official paperwork that makes you health-wise dependent on them until you're 26. You know what I mean? Like, you, family, the idea of which we have it, is largely a social construct, and I challenge you during this time to make your family not a social construct and make it an intentional part of your life of your choosing. On the 20th, there's then a new moon at 28 degrees of Cancer, and this new moon is interesting because there was a new moon in Cancer last month, but it was an eclipse, so it was very different. This new moon is at the tail end of the sign, so we've had two new moons in Cancer this year, which is rare, and this is around wanting the new cozy Cancer new beginning, but totally having to, again, be like, okay, if I want to make myself feel safe, what does that really mean that I have to face in terms of the larger world? Like, how does me making myself safe have an impact on everyone? I can't go out and buy all this shit on Amazon that'll make me feel better if I know that that's exploiting those workers. Like, that's just one example of what can show up during this. There's an awareness of what abundance means in terms of responsibility, and this, again, tying up this focus on Cancer Capricorn over the last 18 months. The newness around this, the new beginning, is amidst the Jupiter Saturn Pluto pileup. It is directly, exactly opposite Saturn in Capricorn. So this is a huge, like, if you don't go back to deal with what you need to go back to deal with, it's gonna fuck you up when you try to plant seeds in completely fucking terrible soil. I'm cussing so much. I'm gonna get a comment about someone who doesn't get my humor and my identity, and it was like, I get those comments a lot from people who are like, you look so creepy and you're so whatever, and I'm like, that's kind of the point, dude. Basically, this new moon is a catalyst, even though it is of that new moon nurturing energy. It's like, how are you gonna actually nurture yourself, bitch? Can't go around it, have to run straight through it. On the 22nd, the sun enters Leo, which is, again, like, not really as dramatically beautiful as one would think, just because it's still in a, the sun is entering Leo and by degree is still close to opposing Saturn, so even though the next few weeks will be more Leonian and a bit more dramatic and uplifted, it'll still have a tone of a little bit of that weirdness, even though, I mean, it's better than having the sun in Cancer opposed by, the Mafia in Capricorn. Over the next few weeks, there will be more of a focus on generosity and solar warmth, so that is nice to look out to. Be more generous during the next few weeks of Leo season. I love that keyword for Leo, generosity. On the 27th, Jupiter in Capricorn is sextiling Neptune in Pisces, and this is a year-long transit where sextiles ordinarily are very weak, like, they're kind of a better than nothing, like, at least you're kind of harmonious. But because this is an outer planet transit and it's coloring 2020, it's a more pivotal sextile than usual. Jupiter in Capricorn is in its fall, and Neptune in Pisces can help it out a bit with this sextile. That Jupiter in Capricorn being the expansion that takes a lot of cold, hard work, like, the things that we get to the top of the ladder will take us climbing the goddamn ladder and putting every step with intention and diligence and mindfulness and, like, scraping the container clean to get everything out. Sextiling Neptune in Pisces means that there's opportunity to actually achieve dreams here. Sextiles are aspects of opportunity, and Neptune can be the dream, it can be the pedestal, it can be the otherworldly spiritual breakthrough. That this long, hard, like, summer can be made into something beautiful, and this is a reminder at the end of the month that that potential is still there, that the more barrenness is around, the more openness there is to make that ground fertile. So how are you expecting this July to play out for you? How is this drama, you know, what do you know is happening in your chart along with this? What are your stories coming up? I would love to hear from you. Now let's pull a tarot card for some more guidance for July 2020. We have Justice reversed. Justice is the card of Libra. It is the card of the scales and of writing and of righting the wrongs and of getting justice. And with this inverted, there's not going to be a solution here. There's either going to be an unfair outcome or there's going to be no resolution at all. So just know that this July is having a lot of things coming to the surface, a lot of drama is manifesting, and it's not necessarily the time to expect the drama to be sorted out until Virgo or Libra season, probably, when things are more, I mean, not that 2020 is chill at all, but there is a less less explosive quality to the rest of the year. And this is like, the shit is all being aired out. The power is not an equal partnership. We are just letting everything arise right now. Let's, for a final word of guidance, pull a Work Your Light Oracle deck card and see what arises through that. If I could pull out a card. Warrior woman, have you answered your deepest calling? I mean, if you're not, you know, primally acting in a primal place of like pure duty right now, your shit's probably falling apart. Like if you're trying to work for someone else's agenda, like the universe is probably giving you so many signs that it's just not gonna work and it's not sustainable to, like, I'm thinking of the metaphor of working a corporate 9-to-5 when you know you're supposed to be a yoga teacher. Like that can only continue for so long before either you get miserable or the universe cuts that off from happening. If you're not answering your call right now, like get on that shit. This is quite literally the last weeks of Saturn, of the nodes in Cancer and Capricorn. Or not the nodes, but eclipses in Cancer and Capricorn. There is no more setting up a foundation that will carry you for the rest of your life. Like if you're not harnessing the complete apocalyptic newness that is available now, this opportunity will not be as seamless in the future. And that's not out of fear, but that is of actually the structure of reality asking you to like be that warrior woman, like whether or not you're a woman, be that warrior woman and go out and compassionately create the life for yourself out of the barrenness that the world is in right now. If you enjoyed all this and you would like a private reading from me, I would love to read from you during this time. Everything is down below, along with information about Rashi, my company, which connects spiritual practitioners with their ideal clients. So if you are a spiritual practitioner, check out Rashi down below, check out BetterHelp down below. If that sounds like something that you need right now, you need it right now, you probably do. We all need someone to talk to right now. Otherwise, make sure that you like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and make sure that you comment letting me know down below how you're vibing with all the drama this July. Sending so much love, and I will see you in the next one.